Students, this is class number 8. Look at the simple question on the board. In the following sets, state whether A is equal to B or not. Just it is enough if we write whether the given sets are equal or not equal. Statement enough. Need not to go for proving. Proving not required. Reason not required. It is enough if you write whether A is equal to B or not. First one, you check both set A. Set A is containing A, B, C, D. Set B is containing D, C, B, A. You decide, students, are the sets or both the sets equal? Are they equal? Yes. I told you, students, while writing, while collecting elements to the set, order never matters. While collecting elements to the set, order does not matter. That means B, C, B, A is same as A, B, C, D. Therefore, set A should be equal to what? Set B. First question, answer is set A is equal to set B. Second one, come to the second question, students. Set A is containing 4, 8, 12, 16. Set B is containing 4, 8, 16, 18. We don't have 12. In set B, we don't have 12. Set A is containing 12, but set B is not containing 12. Are they equal? No. Equal means should have same, exactly the same elements. Equal sets means both the sets should have exactly the equal same elements, right? Okay, set A is not equal to set B. You come to question number 3. So question number 3. So in question number 3, so set A 2, 4. Set A equals 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Set B. So all X, set B contains this type of elements. Which type of elements? X. So your such that this column represents such that what that X is be explained here. X andre enu anta illi barithane. X is positive even integer and X is less than or equal to 10. Positive even integers. Tell me integers, students. So you know the integers very well. 0, 0 plus or minus 1, plus or minus 2, plus or minus 3, so on. Set of integers. We need X is positive even integer. Tell me positive even numbers. So write plus 2, plus 4, so on. Positive, 0 even number, but it is not a positive even number. 0 even number, but it is not a positive even number. Positive even numbers are plus 2, plus 4, plus 6, so on. Plus 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Now, less than or equal to what? 10. I can take 10. X can be equal to 10. I can take 10 also, because X can be equal to 10 also. So write it. Are they equal, friends? Yes. Set A is equal to set B. Set A and set B are equal. So next, let's move on to fourth question. Question number 4. So come to that question number 4. So question number 4 is, so set A, set of all X, X is a multiple of 10. Tell me multiples of 10, students. X such that X is a multiple of 10. Multiple of 10. So tell me multiples of 10. So 10 ones are 10. Plus or minus 10. Minus 10 is also a multiple of 10.
Next, 10 twos are 20. Next, plus or minus 30. Correct? 30. So on. Now, set be given 10, 15, 20, 25. Are they equal or not equal? Not equal. Set A is not equal to set B. Set A is not equal to set B. I hope you got complete idea about equal sets. So let us solve one more question, students. Students, look at this one more simple question. Are the following pair of sets equal? If they are equal, write the reason, give reason. So look at this, students. Solution. First question, set A given. Tell me the elements of set A, 2, 3. Now write the set B. Set B contains X. What that X is? Being X point here, X is a solution of this quadratic equation. Solve that quadratic equation, you are going to get solution. So X squared plus 5X plus 6 equals 0. So 6, 2, 3 is a plus. Solve that by using factorization method. Factorize that x square plus 2x plus 3x plus 6 equals 0. So write what is common? X plus 2 plus 3. X plus 2 equals 0. Tell me factors. X plus 3 into x plus 2 equals 0. So x values, x is minus 3, x is minus 2.
Correct. Tell me solutions of that quadratic equation.
Minus 3, minus 2. Minus 3, minus 2, set B. So minus 3, minus 2. Are these two sets equal, students?
No. So by direct vision, so if we see that directly, it's so clear, set A is not equal to set B.
Set A is not equal to set B because both A and B are having different elements. Elements, right? Next, come to second one. Second one, set A. So tell me set A elements. X is a letter in the word. Letters in the word follow. Collect the letters to form a set. F, O, L, W. F, O, L, W. Correct. Now you write the elements of the set B. Wolf. So wolf. So W, O, L, F. Are both elements the same, students? Yes. Wolf follow. Both of them are having same, exactly the same elements. Set A must be equal to set B. Set A is equal to set B. I hope you understood, students. Let us go for one more question. Students, let us discuss about that subsets. From that name itself, the meaning lies in that name itself. Subset. Subset means sub. What do you understand by that word sub? Sub means part. Part of the set. So part of the set. Look at this, students. I take one set. Set A. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You collect some elements from that set and form one more set. B, set B, set B. So 1, set B, 1, 2, set C. So 2, 3, set D, 4,
set D, empty set, set F. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Observe these sets, students. They are all these sets are the parts. Part, correct?
Not part. Part means picking some elements and making one more set. Taking some elements and making one more set. Taking some elements and that name, definition, everything. That full definition lies in that name itself. Sub. Adalino sub arthagalado, bered bado. Adi sub. Is it a sub or main? Is it sub of this or main of this? This is sub for this. This is main for this, right? Main set, subset. Part of the set. I hope B is subset of A. Because every element of B belongs to A. B is subset of A. Why B is subset of B? A. Each element of B is an element of A. C is subset of A. Because each element is an element of A. So D is element of subset of A. E, empty set. Point. Every null set is a subset of every set. Null set is a subset of every set. Null set is a subset of every set. Keep that in mind. One more. F. Every element of this set F belongs to set A. F. Elements of F belongs to set A. Therefore, F is also a subset of A. F is subset of A. A is subset of F. Correct? A is subset of F. F is subset of A. So you can discuss this property. Look at this one. If A is subset or equal to B, A is subset or equal to B, and or write the argument. If A is subset of B and B is subset of A, if A is subset of B and B is subset of A, so this implies A must be equal to B. This implies A must be equal to B. This is possible. This is possible only when they are equal. A is subset of F. F is also subset of A. It's possible only when they are equal sets. It is possible only when they are equal sets. I hope you understood what that subset is. Usually, for subset, we use this symbol. This symbol means contained in. That means B is contained in A, C is contained in A, D is contained in A, F is contained in A. We have one more symbol. This symbol contains. That means this symbol can be used for subsets. This is called as superset. Superset. Contains means some superset. A is B is subset of A, whereas A is superset of B. How to use this symbol? I explain how to use this symbol. Look at this, students. B is subset of A. B is subset of A, whereas A is superset of B. A is superset of B. Superset. B is contained in A, whereas A contains B. Contained in, contains. I hope you understood. Now define subset, students. So what is subset? Define subset. Every element of set belongs to that given set. Then B is called as a subset of A. Now I go for defining that. I define that. Set A is called subset of B. Subset
of set B. Set A is called subset of set B if X belongs to A implies X must be the element of B. X ಅನ್ನೋದು A ಆಗಿದ್ರೆ X ಅನ್ನೋದು ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಬೇಕು ಬಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇರಬೇಕು. ಸೊ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಯು ಟೇಕ್ ಸೆಟ್ ಎ 1 2, ಸೆಟ್ ಬಿ ಸೊ 1 2 3 ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಸೋ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಸೆಟ್ ಎ ಈಸ್ ಸಬ್ಸೆಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೆಟ್ ಬಿ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಅಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್ X belongs to A. X means element of the set A. Belongs to Arnirodu. Belongs to A given A. X anadu A litre. X anadu A na element agidre. X B na element agirbeku. For example, so 1 belongs to A. Correct. 1 is an element of A. So this implies 1 is also an element of B. So 2 is an element of A. This implies 2 is also an element of B. Therefore A is subset of B. A is subset of B. Right. I hope you understood this completely. Now let us go for remember the following. So remember the following. Let us use this. Remember the following. So remember the following. So look at this, friends. So remember the following. First point, if A is subset of B, and B is subset of A, this implies A is equal to B. Both A becomes subset of B and B becomes subset of A only when A and B are equal. Second point, A is subset of B, B subset of A is equal to B. So right. Second point, A. So right. A is subset of B. So we call this B as superset of A. Number of subsets of set A is 2 power n. Number of subsets of a set A is 2 power n, where n represents number of elements of the set A. N is number of elements of set A. N represents number of elements of the set A. Example, set A 1, 2, 3. So let us write. You go on writing subsets of A. So write B, set B 1, set C 1, 2, set D 3, set E, subset E 1, 2, C, F, 2, 3, E, F, G, G, 1, 2, 2, 3, 1, 3, H, 1, 2, 3, I, M, is set, Look at this, friends. For this set A, I can write these subsets. These are the possible subsets. These are all the possible subsets of set A. Count the number of subsets. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8. Totally there are 8 subsets that could be obtained using 2 power n. So 2 power n. So 2 power n is 3. 2 cube 8. Number of subsets. Number of subsets of a given set is 2 power n. I hope you understood. So now let's go for one more point. So one more point. Now students, one more point. Empty set is a subset of every set. Null set is a subset of every set. So one more point. And every set is a subset of itself. Every set is a subset of itself. A set is a subset of itself. Every set is a subset of itself. So one more point. So this means contained in means subset. Contained in means subset. The meaning of this symbol is contained in means subset. For example, A 1 2 so B 1 2 3 set A is contained in set B. Elements of set A contained in set B. So A is contained in set B. Elements of set A are contained in. So next. So this means contains means superset. Contains means superset. Means B contains A. B contains A. B is a superset of A. A is subset of B, whereas B is superset of A. I hope you understood these things well. So we shall stop this class, students. We shall continue in the next class.